हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज़ डॉक्टर घनश्याम चौहान, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर, पीएचडी मंडल्स कॉलेज ऑफ फार्मेसी शाहदा। आई वेलकम यू इन द सेशन ऑफ सोशल एंड प्रिवेंटिव फार्मेसी। स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई विल गिव प्रेजेंटेशन ऑन डेंगू। व्हाट इज़ डेंगू? इट इज़ नथिंग बट द वायरस विच प्रोड्यूसेस द सिम्टम्स लाइक मलेरिया। द डेंगू इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज डेंगू मलेरिया, एंड दिस वायरस इज nothing but the flu virus, which is accompanied by the Flaviviridae family, and this virus is able to produce the dengue fever, which is become life threatening also. This dengue virus can be carried by the culprit. It is called Aedes aegypti. So this is the mosquito which carries that virus, and it can be spread through the saliva of this mosquito, and they will spread that saliva through their mouth, and they are inserting into the human being, and they are doing transmission from one human being to the another human being, and they are producing the various symptoms like fever, common cold, chills, pain in the joints, gastric disturbances, diarrhea, etc. And this virus is RNA virus. It is single stranded RNA virus, and they are also having four subtypes. There are four serotypes are there. Now if you see the specialty of this mosquito, in last lecture also we have discussed regarding the chikungunya. It is the same culprit, it is the same animal, same insect. So they are also having the same characteristics, as the white spots are there on their legs, and also white spot at the corner of their body. Here you can see. So you can easily identify those mosquito. They are having size somewhat lesser than the normal mosquito, but they are very active as compared with the other mosquito. And also we have discussed their speciality. They will bite you in the daytime. If they will bite you in the daytime, they are able to produce this typical disease, dengue. And this dengue is very common in Asian as well as in the African countries. It can be caused by this Aedes aegypti mosquito, and also there is another species. It is called Aedes albopictus. So both the type of this type of mosquitoes are responsible, both the strains are responsible for production of dengue malaria. Now identification of Aedes aegypti mosquito. The mosquito is totally black except white spot on body and head regions. The mosquito can be recognized by white markings on legs and marking in the form of the lyre on the thorax. The mosquito originated in Africa but is now found in tropical and subtropical regions throughout the world. The mosquito is smaller in size as compared to all the other mosquitoes, and size it 3 to 4 millimeters. The flight is not more than 100 meters from the host. It has fast flight as compared to other mosquitoes, and more active and receptive. She usually attacks on lower part of body, especially on the ankle part, feet part, back of the human, and when you are laying down on the floor, so it is easily find any part of your body. Here you can see the size of the egg. They are cylindrical in shape, just like sickle shape. Here, these are the larva eggs of this Aedes aegypti. Identification of eggs: they are raft shaped, boat shaped, or banana shaped. Eggs are laid in separate single and not in cluster shaped. That is why chance of their spread are more, therefore better chances of their survival. When laid, they are in white shaped, means when they are led by the mosquito, they are having white shaped, but sooner it becomes black, but after a few period they will develop into the black color. The eggs survive for very long time, they are very tough, for very long time they will survive intact and reaches high temperature to 40 degree Celsius. Means they can compatible with 40 degree Celsius temperature also, means they are thermolabile. Now this is the structure of Aedes larva. This is the structure, how they are looks. They are just look like caterpillar. This larva look like caterpillar. After that they will develop into the mosquito. Here you can see, this is the larva of Aedes aegypti. They will fly on the, they will float on the water. That's why they like the moist places where they can float and they can develop themselves. That's why we have to break this chain by avoiding or by giving the space to regenerate, to do their production, reproduction. So because if we will decrease the space when they can lay their eggs and develop into the larva, and this larva, if they won't get water for float for their development, they can't survive. Here it is a pupa of Aedes aegypti. Pupa is the developing stage of the larva when it will get crowded into the whole mosquito. Emerging adult from pupa. So from this pupa, means from this larva caterpillar, it will develop into the mosquito. It will leave its old body, that old coat sheet, it will leave that and it will develop into the another structure. And now it is ready to fly and it will develop into the mosquito. Now this is the life cycle of Aedes mosquito. Here is the adult, the ovulation occurs, and the after that the egg will be liberated, and after that egg liberation, hatching occurs, developing into the larva, and from the larva stage the population, means developing stage from larva to the mosquito, adult mosquito, is a pupa. It is the next stage of this larva which will develop into the mosquito, and the various temperature are required here. For example, 22 degree Celsius required for oviposition, and for hatching 13 degree Celsius, and from this emergence from pupa, it leaves this body of pupa, it is just like caterpillar, and develop into the adult. Require 18 degree Celsius. So this is the life cycle of this mosquito Aedes aegypti. How to eradicate larva? Now this point is very important, because what is our aim? To do the prevention. Prevention is better than cure. So if you will prevent this stage of larva stage, there is no growth occur and there is no formation of mosquito, no biting, no spreading, no transmission, no any symptom, and no any treatment required. So all the stages will be prevented, all the stages will be bypassed if you will do this thing, to do the eradication of larva. That's why these points are very important, try to recall and try to write in examination as well. So for that, first is chemical control. For chemical control, you should use the larvicidals. So Temiphos, this is the chemical, 1% and granules, and 50 EC, if you will take in composition. So it is a good larvicide, it will kill all the larvas. Next is IRS, indoor residual spray. So that spray, if you will take, it contain the delta metrine 5% for adult mosquitoes. So that spray also, now in the various formulations, various by the various trade name like heat spray, and the another spray like all out spray. So various sprays are available in the market that you can purchase, and you can spray on the mosquitoes or the where the shelters, at the shelters of mosquito where they are taking their shelters, where they are staying, they are finding themselves. So you should identify those spaces, those localities, and you should apply that sprays into the corners of your bed, into the flower spot, or wherever you will find that area where they will find their shelter, they will hide themselves. Fogging or space spraying. So deltametrine 1.5 EC for adult mosquito, that also you can use for fogging. And also in last lecture I have discussed about the various chemicals that also you should use, because mosquito is same, whether it is for chikungunya or dengue, mosquito is same. Both are having same type of shelters, same type of eradication you should use. Now biological control by bacteria powder, bacteria bacillus, thuringiensis, this is also one of the way by which we can control those larvae. And this is also another good way to decrease their numbers, fish stocking. If you will use that fishes like tilapia or gambusi fish, so this can be eradicated. They will kill, because what they will eat the larva, the egg or larva. The fish like to eat these larva and that eggs. They are nothing but the food for the fish. That's why there was a slogan few years back, Gappi Masa Pada, and you should avoid the mosquitoes. So like that, this tilapia fish, it is better way to eradicate those larvae and eggs. Environmental control by removing bedding sites. You know what are the various bedding sites you should identify. And in this lecture also I will show you what are the various bedding sites for mosquitoes. So bedding sites should identify and remove them, mechanically remove by your hands or by using your servants. You should remove that breeding sites where they can breed, where they can lay their eggs. Means that it may be water tank or it may be any pot, it may be any tire or like that. By filling ditches with earth or concrete. So you should fill it with concrete or with the cements. By in this fashion, you should avoid this. What is dengue? It is an acute febrile viral disease characterized by sudden onset, fever for 3 to 5 days, intense headache is a symptom of this dengue. After that, myalgia, it is nothing but the pain into our muscles. Arthralgia, there is pain into your joints. Retroorbital pain, pain into your eyesight or eye, below your eye. Anorexia, loss of appetite. GI disturbances, GI upset, diarrhea like condition, and skin rashes. The causal agents is flavivirus, from belong the family Flaviviridae. There are 4 stereotype dengue are there, stereotype 1, 2, 3 and 4. 4 subtypes of these viruses has been found or developed. So they are having size near about 50 nanometer. These viruses are having size 50 nanometer and they contain single stranded RNA. This is the RNA virus which includes into this mosquito. They carries the RNA virus. Vector is ineffective female Aedes mosquito. So this is the female Aedes mosquito which carries that virus. Mainly Aedes aegypti. Incubation period is 4 to 7 days, but it varies from 3 days to 14 days. That depends on the patients. Worldwide distribution, if you will see, it is all over the world, along with from the America continent to the Australian continent, everywhere you will find. But now in current condition, it has been eradicated from such area also. Now it is only available in African and Asian countries mostly, but it is also available in some countries like Panama or Mexico or Colombia, Cambodia, the countries like Chile, Brazil, here like Sudan, Nigeria, Tanzania, Botswana, Sierra Leone, Guinea, after that here India, Pakistan, some part of China, Myanmar, Sri Lanka, Indonesia, Jakarta, after that Bali, Sumatra, some part of Australia, New Guinea, Indonesia. So in this part we will find this epidemic. Now this point you need to concentrate. What are the various habitats where they can lay their eggs? How we can eradicate this disease? So firstly you should identify at which place the mosquito take their shelters. So these are the place in the tires, empty tires which are useless. So if you, the rainwater will be accumulated into this tire, so definitely there will be the production of this mosquito will be there, and they will increase their numbers. It will, these are the breeding sites. Here this is garbage tank and empty bottles. So various garbage places which are nearby your home, definitely these are nothing but the place for breeding of this mosquito. So lots of mosquito will breed here. And also the plastic bottles or the garbage areas, various empty pots where the mosquito can easily develop. They can breed themselves and they can increase their numbers. The old tires where you can see the water has been accumulated, and they are the sites for the hiding and breeding site for this mosquito. Here the toilets which you are not using from so many days, they are also find the space for their hiding. The tree holes, so in some countries in tree holes also, because at that place they are finding the moist, and it is the area where they will having a condition, specific condition in which the growth will occur. Here the flower pots where the water is there, moisture is there, it is a favorable condition for their development. Here you know other plants, various flower plots where you are increasing your germination, you are doing farming or plantation, various plants you are using. If you are the nature lover, definitely you are also having this problem with you of mosquitoes. Here empty paint buckets and packets also, so here also the lots of mosquito will find their shelters. And obviously the discarded old furnitures, so these are also place where the mosquito can immediately find themselves. They will hide themselves, they will stay there for longer period. Air conditioners and air coolers, when you are not changing the water daily, or if you are keep aside, if they are not in use, so that in that place also the mosquito will find themselves secure here. They will stay there for longer period. So this is the place where they will find moist. It is a favorable condition for their development and also for breeding. Open and broken septic tanks, it is also very bad condition. Not only this mosquito but also lots of bacteria viruses will flourish in that area. Broken water sewerages. So why I'm telling this, because you should know what are the various place. You should educate others. If I will educate you, if I will teach you, you will also teach this thing to others. Because what is our main point? To do the prevention. Prevention is better than cure. So if you'll find what are the various places where this mosquito can find their shelters, so what you will, so if you'll find these places, immediately you will close it, you will close the lid, or you will remove the water, or you will take some steps to decrease their shelter place, or you will do some steps to avoid these things, to avoid these open pots or these things where the mosquito can easily get or easily hide themselves into those places. Old toys and plastic utensils. So in this also, in this plot or in this area also, the pots which are not, which are unused, and when you are keeping them on your terrace or the place where you are not going frequently, so in that place also if water will accumulate there, so it is easily place where the mosquito will do their breeding. They will reproduce themselves, they will lay the eggs, larva will produce. So what you will do? Either you should remove these places, you remove these spots from this place, or you should use the oil so that the oil will not allow to survive that lava, or you should do that you should change their position so that no accumulation or no water from the rainwater will be accumulated or will be collected in these spots. That things you can do, or simply you should sell them into the shops where the garbage can be sold. Water mountains, here also you should daily you should change the water from these water fountains so that there should not be any larva or any eggs. If you should change it twice in a week, that you should do continuously. Some key facts about dengue and dengue hemorrhagic fevers. What is hemorrhage? Means bleeding. Bleeding increases. So due to this dengue fever, they will increase the bleeding from the all the part of our body. For example, from the intestine, from the liver, from the blood vessels, from everywhere. Bleeding occurs. So dengue is the mosquito-borne infection that causes the severe flu-like illness. So it will produce a severe flu-like illness, and person want the bed rest or person need to be hospitalized if condition is very severe. Global incidence of dengue has grown dramatically in recent decades. So from the last decades, 2-3 decades, the incidence has been increases, and the virus has also become very strong because they have developed the various recent serotypes 1, 2, 3, 4. Means virus is changing its structure, they become more resistant. The drugs which was effective for earlier type of viruses of dengue, now they are not effective. So you have to go for the another drug because virus has become resistant to those drugs. About 2/5 of the world population are now at the risk due to this dengue. Dengue is found in tropical and subtropical climates worldwide, mostly in urban and semi-urban areas. You will find very less in rural areas. It is fact. Dengue hemorrhagic fever is a leading cause of serious illness and death among children in some Asian countries. In some Asian countries, it becomes headache because this dengue also taking the life of kids, and it's fact. Dengue is found in tropical and subtropical regions around the world, predominantly in urban and semi-urban areas. Global burden of dengue incidence. Dengue hemorrhagic fever, a potentially lethal complications, was first recognized in 1950 during dengue epidemics in Philippines and Thailand. So it has been found in 1950 in Philippines and Thailand. There was 4 districts but closely relates virus that cause dengue, dengue virus 1, 2, 3 and 4. So 4 distinct types has been found out of this dengue virus. The incidence of dengue has grown dramatically around the world in recent decades. Some 2.5 billion people, 2/5 of the world population, are now at risk of dengue. WHO currently estimates there may be 50 million dengue infections worldwide each year. In 2007 alone, there was more than 890,000 reported cases of dengue in the world of each 26,000 cases were of dengue hemorrhagic fever. In 2007, Venezuela reported over 80,000 cases, including more than 6,000 cases of dengue hemorrhagic fever. Some 2.5 billion people, 2/5 of world population, are now at risk from the dengue. WHO currently estimated that there may be 50 million dengue infections worldwide each year. Causes of bleeding places of Aedes aegypti. So where are the bleeding places that you will find out? More urbanizations. So nowadays lots of urbanization has been occurred and is progressing steps it is going on. Poor sewerage and drainage system. So in the Asian countries, especially in India, you will find very poor sewerage condition is there. Nobody is paying attention towards the sewerage. If we are having any pandemic, then and then we become conscious. Otherwise, nobody is paying attention toward these conditions, because we are not investing our money, our mind on our health sector. Poor water supply system in cities and leakage of water. So if water leakage is there, it also give chance to do the breeding of these viruses, these mosquitoes. And also we are in poor water supply. Poor waste management and its disposal, that is also very bad thing. We don't know where to dispose the water, waste water, and we are throwing the waste water on the road. That is a bad thing. Storage of empty bottles, where to dispose the bottle, that also we don't know. Though we are educated, but we don't know where to dispose that empty bottles. Old tires, we are throwing our garbages nearby our area. We are throwing our garbage in the side of, in front of others' home, not in front of our home. That is also a very bad thing, but it is also affecting our health, that we don't know. And plastic toys on roof, we are throwing the plastic toys on the roof or the places on the terrace or any place where it can fill with the rainwater and it will develop the condition for breeding. Standing and uncover water bathrooms and kitchen in the pictures or other utensils. So it is also a very bad thing. So uncover water bathrooms are there. So due to which also the water can be go here and there, and it will also give rise to the breeding. Standing water in ornamental plants. If you are using any ornamental plant like money plant, or you are having the plant like palm trees or any palm which you are keeping in your home, so it is also developing the condition for breeding purpose of that mosquitoes. Transmission of the disease. Dengue viruses are transmitted to human through the bites of infected females, Aedes mosquitoes. Mosquitoes generally acquire the virus while feeding on the blood of an infected person. Mosquito, if it bite with the infected person, then it will carry that virus along with them and it will increase their numbers. After the virus incubation for 8 to 10 days, an infected mosquito is capable during probing and blood feeding of transmitting the virus of the rest of its life. Infected female mosquitoes may also transmit the virus to their offspring by trans-ovarial transmission. That is also very bad things. So from mother to the fetus, the transmission of that virus will occur into the mosquitoes. So they will transfer through the eggs into the next generation. But the role of this is sustaining transmission of the virus to the human, that not has been defined. Signs and symptoms of the disease. Dengue fever is the severe and flu-like illness that affects infants, young children and adults, but seldom causes death. Means they are rarely causing death. But nowadays, in some children, in some infants, they will become the life-threatening. The clinical features of dengue fever vary according to their age and patients and their immunity and their severity of the viral load. Infants and young children may have a fever with skin rash. Other children and adults may have either a fever or the classical incapacitation disease, an abrupt onset of high fever. High fever will occur almost for 3 days. Patient may have high fever, means the temperature won't lay down, and cutaneous hemorrhage will occur from the various parts of your body. Means from the mucus, from the mucosa of your any part, it may be intestine, it may be your respiratory system, the hemorrhage means bleeding will occur. It is very bad thing, bleeding occurs, and severe headache will also occur. Platelet depletion, platelet can be decreased. Pain behind the eyes, pain will develop. Muscle and joint pain will also develop, and skin rash is very common in all the patients. Treatment of the dengue fever. There is no specific treatment for dengue fever. Maintenance of the patient's circulating fluid volume is the central feature of dengue hemorrhagic fever care. There is no vaccine to protect against dengue. Although progress is underway developing a vaccine against the disease, the main problem is that so far as in no animal dengue symptoms appear. So it is a good thing that like pandemic COVID-19, it will not develop to any other animal like any cattle, any horse or cow or buffalo or any pets like dog or cat like that. So it is a good thing it will not spread among the another animals. Preventive and control. At present, the only method of controlling and preventing dengue virus transmission is to combat the vector mosquitoes. It is very, very good thing. You should control the mosquitoes. In Asia and the Americas, Aedes aegypti breeds primarily in man-made containers like earthenware jars, metal drums, concrete cisterns, means concrete tanks where you are accumulating or we are collecting the waters used for domestic water storage, as well as discarded plastic food containers, used automobiles tires and other items that collect rainwater. It is very, very bad thing that we are collecting, we are arranging, though we know these things. If you don't know, then it is understandable, but we are knowing that things, that it will accumulate the water, rainwater, and it will spread the infection. Still we are doing the same thing. In Africa, the mosquito also breeds extensively in natural habitats such as tree holes and leaves that gather to form cuff and catch water. So if it occurs naturally, then we can understood, but if it occurs artificially by the negligence of human being, so it is very, very worse and very bad things to us. Curative measures. Only paracetamol and pandemol tablets and syrups. Pandemol is nothing but the, it is having active ingredient of paracetamol, painkillers only. So only you should use the painkillers like paracetamol in syrup also, it is sufficient to treat. Whereas aspirin and ibuprofen are not recommended in this disease. Take plenty of water and juices to counterbalance your electrolyte, because electrolyte has been decreased in your body. That's why you have to give that. Dextrose in case of leakage of plasma in DHF. Nursing of patients is very important. Means nursing means you should take the proper care of patients. You should check the patients periodically, and you should ask them the questions, what is their conditions. If they are having any pain, if they are having complaining regarding any things, you should take the proper care of the patient. It is called nursing. Patient usually recover after 5 to 7 days. If you will take the proper care of patients will recover within 7 days. But if you won't care properly, if you are having negligence regarding patients, so patient can worsen its conditions. That's why proper nursing is very important. Proper taking care of the patients. You should give them proper drug at proper time. You should give them proper food at proper time. You should avoid certain things which they don't require for during the treatments. Surveillance and epidemiological team. The surveillance team has been constituted under the district officer of health, entomologist. Entomologist is the person who is having knowledge of zoology, who has knowledge regarding the insects, who is taking care of the information, and they are collecting the information regarding the insects, regarding the animals like the mosquitoes. So they are the persons who are collecting the information regarding the mosquito, their numbers, how the breeding, how the spreading occurs, in which area where there is more spreading or more transmission has been occurred. They will collect all the information, they will do the survey. CDC officers, it is a center for disease control, and district sanitary inspector, they are also having great role to control the environment, because it is an environment born disease. So we should control the environment. For that we should having the team of sanitary inspectors from the municipalities, from the various nagarpalikas, mahanagarpalikas. So they will having the chat, or they were having the discussion regarding these conditions, and they will take the steps for that. All medical officers of the primary health centers of the respective tehsils, medical specialist as a focal person for curative measures as designed in DSC and TSC of hospitals. So in these fashions, collectively, if we'll, all persons will take the steps into this, then and then we will fight against this dengue malaria. And last and not the least, we are the general citizen of the city, because it mostly occurs in the urban places. So if we become educated, if we will become more aware, more conscious regarding our health, but not only for our, but also for all the people who are living with us, if you are concentrating on that things, if we'll remove the garbages from nearby our area, if we'll keep clean our area free from the bacterial viruses, free from the mosquitoes, then and then we will eradicate, we will prevent this disease completely. Otherwise, it is very difficult to fight against the disease, because it is the root cause of that disease. And we should take a precaution, we should take a steps regarding that disease, regarding that things. Okay, I hope you understood the complete things. And also my request to all the students who are learning the pharmacy, they should not only keep this knowledge up to them, but they should spread this knowledge in all the people who are from non-pharma or non-medical field. They should teach them, they should tell them how to develop awareness regarding these mosquitoes, regarding this dengue and chikungunya. It is very important, because medical and the awareness, health awareness, medical awareness should be there among all the people. So thanks a lot for hearing me, and I hope you understood the whole lectures. If you have any queries, you can ask me. Bye.